In a recent courtesy call to Philippine Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez, the British Trade Envoy to Manila reaffirmed the UK's commitment to boost its economic ties with the Philippines, especially in terms of investments. To talk more about this, we're joined by UK Trade Envoy Richard Graham. Good morning, Mr. Graham. Magandang umaga. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Magandang umaga, Nikki. Good to be with you.
All right. So first off, we know that the UK remains a strong and reputable global partner in trade for the Philippines and the ASEAN. How has trade relations between the UK and the Philippines been over the past years?
So the pandemic's hit us both pretty hard, hasn't it? Our trade is down about a quarter over the last couple of years, but the longer term trend is very positive, Nikki. I see huge opportunities for us in skills, in investment, in a whole series of different sectors that will be good for the economy and good for jobs.
All right. And is the UK always seeking to establish deeper linkages in the region? How do you intend to do so?
So actually, only a week ago, we had an economic dialogue, which is part of this enhanced partnership between our two countries. And this trend of more and more visits between government representatives, the businesses working together, and the people-to-people relations, all of these are looking positive, but they all suffered a bit of a hit, of course, over the last 2 years. And I think what's encouraging is the way that AstraZeneca has played its role in the recovery of the world during this pandemic, and British companies are looking at tech investment here in the Philippines as well as elsewhere as part of our, if you like, Indo-Pacific pivot. That means stronger relationships in the region, as well as stronger relationships with the Philippines.
Let's zero in on those aspects later on. But first, let's talk about your Build Back Better World agenda. Could you expound as well as on the UK's commitment to clean growth and sustainable infrastructure?
Yes, so this was the theme of the G7 meeting last summer, and then, of course, at the COP26 in Scotland in the autumn. And this is about using the financial muscle of the West to try and help the world transition towards cleaner growth and more renewable energy as part of a sustainable world that should mean, if we get it right, that we don't go on being battered by Typhoon Odette and the storms that are hitting the UK later today. So that's the general trend. And of course, people ask, okay, so what's the crucial detail on this? And we're putting a lot of money behind British Investment International, which will be looking at projects, particularly in renewable energy in the Philippines, so that we can help you transition away from some of the older technologies on energy.
Agreed. And concerning trade and investment, what new opportunities are we looking at for the UK-Philippine collaboration? How exactly does the UK intend to welcome more opportunities to promote and grow free and fair markets?
So it's pretty exciting. I mean, there are companies like Wise who've opened their online fintech business here in Manila, and there's another tech investor coming very soon. You've also seen Dyson open, for example, in the Philippines. And meanwhile, on the other side, you've got Jollibee, who are celebrating, in a sense, the fact that so many Filipinos are living in the UK now. They've opened their 8th or 9th restaurant in Scotland, and they've got, I think, plans to roll out 50 over a pretty short space of time. So investment is going both ways. And it's also happening in tech ways. So, for example, the Philippines is using space on one of our satellites, which will help you plan disaster relief and agricultural management issues better.
And Mr. Graham, lest we forget, you know, amid the pandemic that we are all still dealing with, what are the UK's new priorities post-COVID-19 recovery? And how can the UK help the Philippines in its own recovery?
So in many ways, we're all on the same journey, just in slightly different ways and slightly different speeds. We've more or less completely opened up everything now because of the ability to get everybody not just vaccinated twice, but boosted as well. And I think the Philippines is heading in the same direction. And that means, of course, that the economy can come back full steam ahead. And everyone around the world is trying to look at ways of making sure that we all bounce back. We had the fastest growth in the G7 last year, and your growth is coming back too. But of course, at the same time, we have to deal with other challenges to stability, not just the pandemic. And that includes some of the the geopolitical issues in Ukraine, which is a long way from the Philippines, but the ripples reach the Taiwan Straits as well.
Right. And how does the UK seek to promote economic prosperity, not just via trade priorities in technology and healthcare, but also in education?
So education is really key. And I was pleased only a couple of days ago to celebrate the signing of two MOUs with the Philippines, one between our National Skills Academy for Rail with the Philippine Rail Institute. Mm-hmm. And Secretary Tulgade made the point at this celebration that the Philippines is looking to expand your rail network across the country more widely. So that's exciting. And then we also signed another one between Solent University and your maritime regulator, Marina. So both of these MOUs are all about skills and upskilling and seeing the Philippines playing a bigger role in international transport. And we've got some tech that we think will be very useful on this journey.
Mm-hmm. And Mr. Graham, lastly, before we let you go, campaign season has just kicked off here in the Philippines. And following this, what do you think will become of the UK-Philippine trade relationship with the changing of not just the president, but of the entire economic teams? Are you feeling optimistic?
Well, it's really interesting. I mean, I was in Cotabato yesterday with Chief Minister Murad and the new Bang Samoro Authority. And I was looking at some of the posters on the streets with Marcos Duterte on them. And the last time I was in Cotabato, they had posters there with Marcos Tolentino. That was in 1986 when I was traveling around Mindanao. So some things change and some things are very familiar. But I think the key direction of where we want to go to with the Philippines on a really positive trade and investment relationship is that you've liberalized. You've got three great new measures on retail, foreign investment, and public service acts. And we're seeing how we can work more closely with you. So I anticipate that over the next 2 or 3 years, whoever is successful in the presidential elections, that this determination between our two nations to see how we can work more closely at all levels is going to only be positive for both you and for us.
And Mr. Graham, before I go, this is Mike. If I can just butt in and ask you a question. The Times of UK is reporting that the UK government believes Russia has decided to invade Ukraine. In general terms, how will this affect trade relations between the UK, European countries, and will this have an impact on trade relations between the UK and the Philippines?
Well, the tragic thing of any military invasion is always the impact it has, not just on the stability that business requires to thrive, but on people's lives and the damage it will do to the families of Russian soldiers involved, as well as the Ukrainians being invaded, will be immense. And the danger, of course, is that military violence of this kind encourages other authoritarian regimes elsewhere in the world mm-hmm. to try and satisfy their ambitions in a similar way. So that's why we've been trying to very much encourage President Putin to realize that actually this is not in Russia's best long-term interests. It will be destabilizing for the world and it will have a huge backlash on Russia.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And thank you. We were hoping for a good resolution to that issue. Nikki?
All right. On that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Mr. Graham. You stay safe.
Thank you very much, Nikki.